My name's Cami, and today we're going to be making onigiri. There's nothing in here. So the first thing you're gonna need is nori. You could use either this seasoned seaweed that already comes in like packages and stuff like that. It looks like this. Or you could use this that comes in sheets and stuff like that. Okay, and then you're going to need spam, and then you're going to need either one of these onigiri molds or plastic wrap or both, whichever one you like. And then you need water, some furikake, any flavor that you want. You need some rice wine vinegar. You need some rice, obviously. And then finally you need soy sauce. This is optional. It goes along better with the onigiri, but whatever floats your boat.
Hey guys, I'm Cole and I'm gonna show you how to make the rice for our onigiri. So we're gonna take 2 cups of sushi grade rice, level it off, and pour it into the rice bowl. And then we're gonna need one more. Okay, so now we're gonna wash our rice. Just place your rice bowl in the sink and rinse it with cold water. Usually when I make the rice, I'd like to rinse it off about 2 or 3 times. Alright, so after you've rinsed your rice, you're going to want to fill it with water. So if you made 2 cups of rice, you'll fill it up to the 2 line. Each rice cooker should have lines in the bowl. Alright, so after we've turned on our rice cooker, we're gonna start making the spam.
Okay, so next we're gonna be making our spam. So what you wanna do is open up the can, because that would be very helpful. And you just kinda like dump it on the thing. Comes out as a chunk, which is very appetizing. And just gonna slice it up into maybe like 1/4-inch slices. And we have about this much left. You're gonna cut these a little bit thinner. So you're gonna take your thinner slices and put them aside. And then you're gonna take the thicker slices, and you're gonna cut these into cubes. So, just gonna take it lengthwise and cut it into 3. And then turn it the other way, and then cube it. Just like that. Okay, so the first thing you're going to want to do is heat up your pan. And we're just going to wait for that to heat up. Okay, so then we're going to add a little bit of oil in there. Just a little bit, because spam is greasy as it is. I'm just going to slide that around in the pan. Make sure to get most of the bottom covered. So we're just going to wait for that to heat up. And then we are going to add our nice little spam chunks in there. So we're just going to like try to separate all the little clusters. You're just gonna keep cooking it until it gets golden brown on both sides. Okay, so now that our little cubes are done, we're gonna turn off the heat. And we're just gonna take a bowl like this. And we're gonna put a paper towel on the bottom just to like help soak up some of the grease. We're just gonna pour our spam into there. Okay, now we're gonna turn the heat back on. And since there's still a little grease in the pan, we could use our slices. We just put those in there for a little bit. Okay, so now that both sides are cooked, we are going to take a small plate, put another paper towel on it, and just dump our spam onto the paper towel.
Okay, so now after our rice has finished cooking, you're gonna wanna take a small bowl and pour water into it. Okay, so now we have about 1/3 of the rice that we had in our pot. So what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna take a spoon, dip it in some water, and then you're just gonna fluff the rice a bit, just to moisten it a little bit. All right, so after you've done that, your spoon down, you're gonna wanna take some rice vinegar. And you're going to want to pour some into your spoon. And then slowly drizzle it on top of the rice. And then you can mix it around. If the texture doesn't feel right to you, feel free to add a little bit more or however much you need. Make sure you get all the vinegar around. Then you're gonna wanna give it a little taste. All right, it's good. If the texture feels right, if it sticks together and crumbles in your mouth a bit, that's the perfect texture. All right, so for shaping your onigiri, there's two methods. You could use an onigiri mold like this, or you could use plastic wrap and shape it in your hand. I'm gonna use the onigiri mold, just because it's easier. So what you're gonna wanna do is, you're going to wanna take a couple spoonfuls, fill it in about halfway. Let's put some rice, who cares? Fill it in about halfway. Pack it in there tightly. Then, with your spoon, you'll want to make a little hole or section you want for the spam that we made earlier. We're using the cubes and chunks of spam. So, about cubes this size, you'll want to use 2 or 3 of them. For now, I'm going to use 2, and I'll stack them on top of each other. If you want, you could put small ones around it, just to give it more generous. Alright, so now that we have the spam inside the rice, if you want, this is optional, you could take your furikake, open it up, and you could sprinkle a little bit on the inside. That's optional, you don't have to do that. And then you're gonna take a little bit more rice and just cover it up. Make sure you pack it in tightly, or else when you take it out, it will just fall apart. Alright, so we'll continue covering it up with our rice. When you pack it in, you'll want to leave a little bit of space from the very top. Just a little bit. Add a little bit more. Just a teeny bit of space. Alright, and so if you want, if you're making two, you could just fill in the other side. Alright, so after that, you'll take the top part of the mold and slowly push down. Hold it for a couple seconds. Alright, so you'll want to use a lot of force so you could pack it in and shape it. Oh, and if you guys are wondering, you could find an onigiri mold like this at any Japanese market. Pretty easy to find. Or you could buy them online for a couple dollars. Okay, so our onigiri is shaped. We can take our plate. So what you want to do is you'll take off the top part, and then you'll just push down on this part down here. You can take some nori strips, just take one. You need to wet it a bit, just dip it in your water you had from before, and you could take your onigiri. Top and carefully wrap the rice around the bottom like that. And if you see this little hole in here, some molds have them, has a little space there. You can take one more spam cube and just place it in right there, whatever. So yeah, that's the first method.
Okay, so I'm gonna show you like the more conventional method with plastic wrap. So first thing you need to do is get out a piece about this big. Just rip it. You could lay it out like this. Yeah. What you're gonna need to do is make sure you have clean hands. You're gonna wet both of them a little bit just so the rice doesn't stick. Then what you're gonna do is take a little bit of rice, about this much, to add a little bit. You're gonna pick up the plastic wrap and you could just shape it in your hands a little bit, occasionally wetting it so the rice doesn't stick. And then you're gonna take some spam and just press it in the middle there, not too much, just like this. You're gonna take more rice and shape it around the spam. Wrap the plastic wrap around the little onigiri, then you're going to shape it into a triangle. Any other shape that you like. Triangles are, I think, are the most traditional in Japan. So we did that. I'm gonna round out the corners a little bit. This is what it looks like. I'm just gonna set that aside. Okay, so if you're using this kind of seaweed, all you're going to be doing is fold it in half as best as you can. You can just take some kitchen scissors and cut it down the middle. You're just gonna cut a couple strips that you could use, just like the other roasted seaweed that Cole used. Okay, so you have your onigiri. You're just gonna take your seaweed and wrap it around it like this. And the rice should let it stick to it, just because it's a little bit thinner than before. And if you want, you could add another little piece of spam, and you're done. Okay, so for the spam slices, you're just gonna cut these into little sticks, and you're gonna use this as garnish on the finishing plate. And there we go, you're pretty much done. You can just cluster these on the side of the plate, and yeah, that's it.